So we were just driving down the main road, which is actually a really nice road. And this guy, he's already driven off.
Did anyone see the accident?
Good morning, everybody. It's Max and Kim.
Today we're going to Sikihor.
Yeah. We checked out of our Airbnb in Dumaguete. Now we just got to catch the ferry over to Sikihor, where we're going to be spending the next two nights. Thank you. Selamat.
So before you get to go through the ferry terminal, you have to come to Terminal B and pay a 15 peso terminal fee. Alright.
Guten Tag. All clear. Check in and now to get a seat number. The big luggage actually gets checked in, and that fee isn't covered in the ticket fee. So 10 kgs, up to 25 kgs, and up to 50 kgs. This one here is the distance from where you leave the bag to the boat. So because it's a long way to walk to the boat, the price is higher. The further you walk, the more you pay. So this is Dumaguete Terminal, Dumaguete Dock. You have to sit in your designated seat on this boat. It's not a first in, first serve like it was from Lilawan to Dumaguete. And it's air conditioned in here, so it should be a lot nicer.
A few moments later.
And welcome to Sikihor.
Welcome.
Now we just have to find our Airbnb host, Legasi.
He's waiting at the white church.
First impressions of Sikihor though. Absolutely beautiful. I think we're gonna like it here.
Day two.
This is Raymond.
Hello.
How old are you?
Six.
Six, wow. So these are our wheels for the day.
Are you going black or yellow?
Today we're gonna go to Salagdaung, I think, beach. We're gonna put the name there, so if I'm just butchering it, that's the beach. It's known for its cliff jumping spot, so there's two, 8 meter and a 12 meter. And we're off.
So this is where you get petrol from here. Thank you. And you just pour it in the back like that. Selamat po. So we were just driving down the main road, which is actually a really nice road. And this guy, he's already driven off. This guy was in front of us driving. Just pretty much stopped in the middle of the road. So he was right in front of us when he stopped. So even though Kim...
Yeah, he didn't even pull over, he just stopped in the middle of the road.
Yeah, even though Kim braked as hard as we can. So
we
ended up going into the side of him. And both bikes slid over to the side. And they immediately got up and drove off because he has no license. We've got a little bit of scratches here. And the bike is okay. So there's just a little bit of scratches here on the bike, and the front of that is just off. But other than that, it was really lucky that no one was hurt.
Did anyone see the accident?
Are you okay?
Yeah, I'm alright. So the guy in front of me, we were just driving, and the guy in front of me just stopped in the middle of the road. So I tried to slam on the brakes, but I didn't want to swerve onto this, so then still hit the side of him, and then we ended up falling. So the bike's pretty damaged.
We're okay.
Really lucky that we didn't get hurt. He literally stopped in the middle here because this is where our bike bumped into him and the scratches that it rolled over to get onto the side here. So we're just trying to get the bike fixed up as much as we can before we take it back to the rental place.
Yeah.
And then after that we'll head over to the hospital and try to get patched up just for the cuts. But it's actually a miracle that no one was harmed.
Sorry.
No, it's good. Ooh. So we're just getting all patched up here, guys.
More?
I think we're good.
Salamat.
Oh, cool.
The show must go on.
We're all patched up just here at the Lazy Community Hospital. Lazy.
Lazy.
Just here at the Lazy Community Hospital. Just a couple of scratches. We are so lucky that we weren't hurt worse.
Very lucky that the skitter did come with helmets as well, because our heads scraped the ground.
Yep. He's really nice, the guy that we actually crashed into as well. We followed him to the shop where he fixed up the alignment for the scooter, and then followed him here to the hospital to get patched up.
Yeah. So the Filipinos are super nice.
Yeah, accidents happen.
Yeah.
The main thing is that we're all okay. Bikes can be replaced. But we're not gonna let that stop us going to the waterfalls and the cliff jumping spots, because tomorrow we have to go to Bohol, so we really only have today and tomorrow morning to see it.
Yeah.
So even though we're a little bit sore, a little bit stinging, we're gonna make our way there. Maybe not that much cliff jumping today because our feet and Kim's hand is pretty sore.
But it's got salt water, that's good for it. We'll do one jump.
Eventually.
So there is an entrance fee to get into the cliff jumping point here. It's 30 pesos per person for an adult, and then you also have to pay 20 pesos for the scooter to get it in as well. So that should say 30, but it doesn't. And then 20 for a motorbike.
So we just get lots of stamps. Can we use these to send letters?
No way, it's just plastic.
The restaurant here is actually pretty nice. We just had a delicious pork belly just with some rice.
Grilled pork belly.
Yum.
Number one choice.
Kim got a mango shake, which I had half of, because mango is probably my new favorite flavor. It's pretty nice here. You've got two beaches just on either side of the cliff jumping point, and it looks like all of these little huts that people are having their food and luncheon, you can actually rent for 200 pesos. I'm not sure who you pay.
We think that's for the day.
Let's check out the jumps. So this is where the slide is. Out of water. So I guess we will not be using the slide today. So you've got one lower one, and then this one's the higher one here. Too high? You reckon you'll do it?
Oh, you should do it.
About 20 jumps off the high one. It's so much fun. All the people here are really nice. It's just a cool atmosphere and a really cool place to come.
Yeah, we actually didn't try any of the lower jumps. We just liked the big one. And apparently there's lifeguard on duty because the flag is yellow, and that means there is one. I haven't seen him.
They also say the jump is about 12 meters high. It's definitely not 12 meters high. Maybe at low tide it might be a bit higher. I would say it's 8 or 9 meters for the top one.
Day three.
Our bodies are definitely feeling the burn today.
And by burn, we mean bruises.
Yeah, we're a lot more achy. Walking's pretty sore. So we definitely played it down yesterday. We were like, nah, a couple of scratches, because we're in the wars today. But anyway, we just booked our tickets from La Reina, which is the top port in Sighihor, up to Tagabalaran, I think it's called, which is actually the capital of Bohol. It's just on the bottom of Bohol, above the island of Panglao, where we're staying. It costs 730 pesos per person, and the boat actually goes once per day from Sighihor to Bohol, which is at 12:30.
So don't miss it, otherwise you're not going till tomorrow.
But first things first, we can't leave without climbing a coconut tree. Gotta at least try, even though we're sore. How high can you go? Nice! Is it hard?
It hurts.
Hurts your feet? Do you feel high as? Kim's stuck in the tree.
Max is going in for the tree climbing.
Hold tight,
was doing?
Shoes.
Who thought you would do that?
So after I climbed that tree, it really hurt my feet, and I told Maxie to wear shoes, and he didn't want to. But there he is. I want to get some shoes. I also hurt my foot.
All set with the shoes. Hello.
What up? I climbed coconut trees.
Did you get a coconut?
No coconuts though.
Did you not go high enough?
No, it was scary when I went high.
So we just arrived at Larenya Port here on Sikihor. The total costs for the bike came to 2,205 pesos. I think it's $63 Australian that it came out to, which is not bad, it's pretty good. And it was also 400 pesos for the ride from San Juan to Larenya.
Alright guys, that is the vlog.
We're so happy that the whole situation with the scooter came out okay. It wasn't too expensive to fix, and we're all safe. Hopefully this gives you a realistic idea that accidents happen when you're traveling. If you haven't already, make sure you smack that subscribe button in the face. Other than that, stay safe, we'll catch you in the next one.
Bye.
What have you found?
Donut. And it's cheaper to get 5.
Oh wow, that sounds like a good deal. Babe, I guess we have no choice but to get 5 donuts.